ladies and gentlemen. It's a real pleasure for me first to be together with you today. But at first, let me congratulate Apostolos Tsitsikostas, the newly elected president of the European Committee of the Regions, and wish him success. We know each other now for many years. Our cooperation was always very positive, very dynamic and fruitful. So I count on our future cooperation to bring Europe closer to our citizens. So as Jean-David already said it, this conference is the final event of the consultation process to design the new innovation ecosystem work program for Horizon Europe. We already have done a lot, but we have a lot to do. First, you know that this was part of a co-creation process that helped us identify the next actions in order to boost European innovation ecosystems and to meet especially the need of you, the needs of stakeholders. And I'm glad to meet such a great number of diverse stakeholders of the European innovation ecosystem. We already received more than 315 responses from different sectors, regions, during this consultation process, and I would like really to thank you for your useful contribution and for being here today. I would like now to continue by saying that we all know that innovation is a key driver of competitiveness and growth, ensuring jobs and prosperity for our cities, regions, and countries. The reason that I believe so strongly in the important role of Europe to support innovation is the way we can make such a major difference to our whole society with the instruments and policies involved at local, regional, national, and European levels. That's why one of our challenges is really to continue our efforts to bring these different drivers and levels of governance closer together. Like any natural ecosystem, each innovation ecosystem has its own individual character, its challenges and opportunities. They are very much comparable. It takes ingenuity and talent and a real long-term vision to fully exploit their potential. This also requires connecting the actors of quadruple helix: citizens, businesses, public authorities, and academia. Moreover, this requires also attracting talent, innovative companies, building successful partnerships between public and private stakeholders. Together, we have to create connections between local, national ecosystems, integrating them into a wider European ecosystem for startups and scale-ups. That's why we count very much on the Committee of the Regions. The last decade, we witnessed the emergence of major new markets and the global platform economy, facing at the same time the challenges of the climate change, the digitalization, demography. Europe, we know, is a leader, it's a world leader in science. We have only 7% of the world's population, but we are responsible for 20% of research and development and 1/3 of the highest level of scientific publications. But Europe can do better at transforming this into leadership and entrepreneurship. We lack breakthrough and disruptive innovations. And that's why we count on all of you to transform our potential into tangible, concrete actions. That's why for us, creating innovation ecosystems and interconnecting existing ones is of utmost importance to enable build coherent, strong, and viable European market in the new digital era. So let's start first with the main question, the budget. And we all look at the Council this Thursday. I think that, yeah, we are ambitious. You know that we proposed a budget of 100 billion. I really would like to say that's what I'm saying to every single Prime Minister, Minister of Finance, and Presidents in the European Union. this budget for research, innovation, education, it's not just an amount of money. It's an investment in our present and our future. If you'd like really to tackle commonly all the challenges that we are facing today, we need to have tools, instruments, and that means a really consistent and coherent budget. And that was our proposal with the new structure of Horizon Europe, with new tools, now with new questions like innovation ecosystems or synergies. And I will insist on some of them. First, you know that to reach our ambitions, one of the major novelties is the European Innovation Council. The proposed budget is 10 billion. Someone will ask, what is this when we compare with others? But for us, there is a need to see that it will function like one-stop shop for innovators, providing agile support from idea to the market, from the laboratory to scaling up at the market. And when I say agile support, we need to do something more. And here, I will welcome your ideas, because you are facing those challenges on the ground. You know what we can achieve better. At the same time, we already can make some examples. First, a pilot phase has already started, and we have allocated more than 3 billion euro in Horizon 2020. It provides direct support to innovators through two funding instruments. On one side, we have the Pathfinder for advanced research on breakthrough technologies and the Accelerator for highly innovative startups, SMEs, and scale-ups. The Accelerator has already provided support over 500 startups and highly innovative SMEs. In 2019, we introduced a major novelty in offering startups and SMEs access to combined grant and equity finance of up to 7.5 million euro. The first 39 companies awarded with this blended finance were announced in December. Now it will be important to see what are the next steps. I'm very proud of this early success of the EIC pilot, but we also need to improve the overall ecosystem for innovation across Europe. And that's why, that may be the news of the day, in order to boost these European innovation ecosystems, we'll create the European Innovation Council Forum, gathering innovation authorities and agencies in charge of innovation policies and programs. And this forum has this ambition to bring different innovation drivers and level of governance closer together to work on all issues that can boost innovation ecosystems in Europe. The aim is to promote coordination and dialogue on the innovation ecosystems and at the same time connect them with the European Innovation Council. It's not only the European Innovation Council that we have at our disposal. I would like to bring to your attention the importance of the knowledge and innovation communities of the European Institute of Innovation and Technology. They will also provide support with a very strong regional dimension. And believe me, I will pay a lot of attention to their regional initiative. Because if you'd like really to tackle the research and innovation divide, if you'd like really to build a European, real European innovation ecosystem, we can't continue like in some previous period. That's why for me the role of Committee of the Regions here is very, very important. And this topic brings me to one of the main questions, the question of synergies. I know you already heard this beautiful word a lot from the last years, but I would like to offer my firm support together with you to transform this beautiful word synergy in tangible, concrete actions. At my level, I already initiated discussions with other commissioners, and here I'm making reference to Elisa Ferreira, European Regional Development Fund, to to Nicolas Schmidt, European Social Fund, and you know that there is some other possibilities. But now I think that we need really to identify how exactly we can transform those synergies in concrete benefits for our citizens, businesses, and regions. We are thinking about the Seal of Excellence, another good idea, but not really implemented. We would like really to push a more closer relations with the regional smart specialization strategies to see how we can promote and co-fund joint innovation programs. And such programs may support directly innovative SMEs or startups, incubators or innovation hubs, provide technical assistance. Don't forget all the dimension of skills and education. That's a real chance that this time we have research, innovation and education under the same portfolio, because we all know how important it is to have equipped people with the right skills. And that's why I will use all the possibilities that on one side Erasmus Plus is offered for us, but at the same time European Social Fund. And please here pay attention to our initiative of the European University Alliances. We would like really to see that in 4 years it will be possible to have our European universities of the future. And that's why I so much insisted that at the beginning they have research and innovation as crucial part of their work. Of course, work in silo, it's not only on the ground, it's in the European Commission too. On our side, we'll make really some additional efforts to see that this time it will be possible to work at the beginning, not only by looking at the same direction, but really taking into consideration each aspect of the process. And that's why I like so much this co-creation as key word for what we are doing. So I insisted a lot on European Innovation Council, on EIT, KICS, European universities. I don't want really to avoid here to use the reference to missions, because too much when we talk about innovations, it's only about European Innovation Council. Okay, that will be our European Union's unicorn factor if you'd like to do it. But without synergies with the other programs, it will be impossible really to break this work in silo. That's why I will be very glad to see that you pay attention during the next month to our work on partnerships, on missions. We know that's something new. And that's why here there is a role of Committee of the Regions, because above all, what are the missions? That's something that we need to engage citizens. That's something that we would like to show to our citizens, that there is results, there is positive results in their daily lives because we took action at European level. And I will be very glad here to continue this cooperation. Finally, I will continue to pay attention to all innovators, to our champions, and on our side, we'll continue to support the recognition and inducement prizes as instrument for strategic investment innovation. It's a good aspect too. So from our side, we'll continue with the European Capitals of Innovation Awards. And here I would like really to insist on the role of women. We need more women in our European innovation ecosystem. And you know that by 21st of April, we are welcoming all the candidacy for the European Prize for Women Innovators. I very much count on you. So in conclusion, let me thank once again all of you in taking the active role in shaping together Horizon Europe and at the same time our present and our future. I count on your support, on your innovative ideas, on your cooperation, and final word, very fruitful and pleasant discussions. Productive day for all of you. Thank you very much.
Many, many thanks, Commissioner, for this very inspiring speech. President Tsitsikostas.